Hi, welcome to HeArtfully Creating. Today, I just had to do more large hole beads and tube beads. There's actually only really one large hole bead in this one. Basically, the process is still the same as in the previous video I did. Well, it is still the same. Taking sheets of clay and making a base, wrapping them around big cardstock or paper tubes that you can either put on a dowel or something that's oven proof, or just really thick paper, and I just tape it into a cylinder, so depending on the size that you want, and then just adding shapes. You can either pre-bake and work from those forms that I showed you at the beginning, or just do the whole entire thing raw. So you can add the clay on raw onto a base, or you can make a hard base, bake it, and then add to that. If you're doing that, unbaked clay onto baked clay, make sure you use liquid Sculpey or bacon bond or something like that to help it adhere. Mind you, I do see some people who are attaching clay that's raw onto baked clay and they don't seem to use anything, so experiment with that. I've just been learning from watching others and started doing that just because I think you're supposed to. I guess I have tried it both ways and it seems to work, so if you want to make it good and strong, when in doubt, add some liquid clay. So just, I like to have fun with textures. I think the biggest reason why I like sharing this these beads is because I really enjoy taking photos of the work that I do, and I'm not very good at taking just a photo or five photos. I gotta take multiple photos, and the video method presentation is the best way to share all those photos. I don't want to just hide them away. I want to share them, and hopefully even as a visual record for myself, and if they happen to inspire anyone to create some beads, then great. So this is the really large one that I started out, as you saw, if you back it up a little bit, with some little long strands of clay that I rolled out. I do not use an extruder as well. I wasn't going to do any texturing, but once you start, it's hard to stop. So then I just basically sculpted it. So these are more sculptural than anything. And it's a lot of fun. And I have yet to make anything with these beads yet because I just really like having them. And then I made them. And I had some ideas at the time when I was making them, but I have yet to execute those ideas. So when I do, I will make a video about that. So the large one is meant to be like a focal bead that I was thinking of putting sari ribbons into, like a lot of them. Or you could use, some people make cording out of cut t-shirt or jersey fabric. Yeah, whatever you want. It's just that something really big, you gotta make sure it hangs properly if you're making a necklace out of it. So I added mica powder because mica powder has mica power, as you might remember if you watched the previous video. Sorry that it was kind of boring, but I just like mica powder and power. And thank you, Christy Friesen, for seeing that I didn't make a spelling mistake and I really meant mica power. Yeah, so be inspired and then create and make sure you have fun. So here's the rest of it. Yay, that's the almost end of the video. As you can see, we're getting quite a collection of large hole tube beads. I just love the texture. So you can do whatever you want. Have fun. Hope you're inspired, even a little, or just enjoy that. So if you like this, please make sure you click like and share and subscribe it. Subscribe if you want to, that really helps. You can comment below. Any ideas or thoughts would be wonderful. And you can email BERGIECREATION@gmail.com. And if you have any ideas, please let me know. Have a great day and happy creating.